you're filming in an iPhone which does this HDR thing, or the Sony A6400 which shoots in HLG, then when you bring all that in the Premiere Pro, the highlights are blown up and you're like, what the hell is this? Luckily, Adobe has been, you know, working actually on things to be improved. There's a super easy fix I'm gonna show you right away. And one more other thing that will save tons of time going forward where you don't have to use any LUTs or anything. So look at this HDR footage from the iPhone. On the preview, it looks pretty well. You know, of course the sky is bright and all that. It looks pretty nice. Anyways, I'm just dragging it timeline and keep existing format, and you can see that the floor is all blown out. Look at the sky. There's some crazy happening banding or whatever that thing is called. It's just a mess. Super easy fix. You go to sequence settings, and check this checkbox, auto tone matte media, and make sure also that you have the correct working color space. In my case, that's Rec 709. I click OK, boom, it's all done. It works like a magic. However, check this out. If I were to work with S-Log footage and then, you know, bring it in, here's the same footage. It doesn't look that good. Sequence settings, auto tone map is good. You might think, okay, now I need to add all those conversion LUTs and all the other things. Not really. One thing that you can do, and I showed this in the previous videos, you can go to modify, interpret footage, and then you can choose the color space and choose the Sony S-Log3, S-Gamma 3 Cine, because that's what I used. Click OK, and you can see out of the box, it looks really nice. Without the sequence settings, this wouldn't look too good, because check it, you see, it's totally blown out and it doesn't look good. However, there's a really cool thing that you can do, and it's gonna save you a lot of time. You basically click on the Premiere Pro, go to settings, go to general, and here you have a beautiful checkbox that you need to do. Auto detect log video color space. Do that and the magic happens. It does a little bit of refresh here on the preview, nothing changes, but if I were to just drag this S-Log3 footage in a timeline, just let's make sure that I did not have the interpret footage. You see, use media color space from file. I didn't use the color space override that I did previously. It automatically detects the color space from the file. And as soon as I drag that into the timeline, boom, it looks beautiful, almost, because the sequence settings, auto tone map media is not on. As soon as I turn it on, took a while. It got me scared. I was like, okay, this was supposed to work right out of the bat, but it does work. And you know, you're not gonna have to do this over and over again, because as soon as you do those checkboxes for the auto tone map media and also auto detection for the profile, it does it automatically and it's all good. You got me there. And guys, one note, please make sure that your Premiere Pro is up to the date. By the time of recording, I'm on a version 23.3.0. So make sure that it's just up to date so you don't have any other differences. So this is really, really simple thing, how you can avoid using LUTs and how you can fix the highlights. Really hope it's helpful. Leave a comment down below, because you know, I really like to read messages from you guys, and I'll see you all in the next video. Don't forget to keep on creating.